Imagine an AI so advanced, it can transform your words into hyper-realistic videos. That AI is OpenAI's newest creation. But behind the promise of effortless video generation lies a controversy, a cost so steep it's sparking outrage. Some hail it as a game changer, others dismiss it as a ripoff or even useless. Is Sora the future of video creation, or just another overhyped gimmick waiting to implode? Today, we dissect the tech, the hype, and the jaw-dropping price tag that's left Reddit fuming. In December 2024, OpenAI unveiled their latest breakthrough, a text-to-video AI designed to turn simple words into stunning, hyper-realistic videos. The tech world lit up with excitement. Imagine typing a sunset over the ocean and watching it come to life, frame by frame. This wasn't just another AI tool. It was a potential game changer for content creators, filmmakers, and marketers looking to generate visuals at the speed of thought. Headlines from The Verge and Ars Technica called it a revolution, and OpenAI's demo clips showcased a world where creativity had no limits. Text prompts transformed into videos almost effortlessly. But as the hype grew, so did the questions. Could Sora really deliver on its promises? And more importantly, at what cost? Because beneath the excitement, a wave of doubt and frustration was already starting to bubble up. So how does Sora actually turn your words into video? At its core, Sora relies on a diffusion model, a type of AI that starts with random noise and gradually refines it into a clear, coherent video. Think of it like tuning an old TV, where static slowly transforms into a recognizable image. But instead of a single picture, Sora does this frame by frame to create motion. Sora has been trained on massive datasets filled with countless videos and images, learning to predict what each frame should look like based on your description. This is what allows it to generate short, realistic clips with smooth transitions and motion. But here's the catch. Sora works best with simple scenes and short durations. Ask it to create a 5-second clip of a dog running in a park, no problem. But try a 20-second video of a bustling city street with people, cars, and complex interactions. That's where Sora starts to struggle. Objects warp, movements glitch, and consistency falls apart. Sora might be revolutionary, but that revolution comes at a price that could leave your wallet gasping for air. Sora uses a credit-based pricing model where the cost depends on video length and resolution. Want a simple 5-second clip in 720p? That's 60 credits. But if you want a 20-second video in crisp 1080p, that'll drain a whopping 2,000 credits. Now, let's talk subscriptions. The ChatGPT Plus plan costs $20 a month and gives you just 1,000 credits. That's enough for a few short, low-res clips before you're tapped out. If you need more, you'll have to upgrade to the ChatGPT Pro plan at $200 a month for 10,000 credits. That sounds generous, but remember, high-res, longer videos burn through credits faster than you'd expect. When Sora launched, the excitement was electric, but it didn't take long for Reddit to bring the thunderclouds. Over on r/OpenAI, threads filled with frustration, skepticism, and outright disappointment. One user didn't mince words, calling Sora a glorified toy for rich creators. Another summed it up with brutal honesty. Sora's just another AI hype bubble waiting to pop. The core of the frustration? Sora's limitations and high cost. Paying hundreds of dollars for a few seconds of glitchy, low-res video doesn't exactly scream game changer. And when the outputs are inconsistent, with warped objects and awkward motion, it's no wonder users feel like they've been sold snake oil. For many on Reddit, Sora felt less like the future of video creation and more like a cash grab wrapped in hype. When OpenAI unveiled Sora, the promise was clear: a revolutionary tool that could bring your wildest ideas to life in video form. The demos showed stunning, smooth clips generated from simple text prompts. For a moment, it felt like the future had arrived. But when the tool hit the hands of real users, the cracks began to show. Sora excels at creating short, simple videos: a dog running in a park, a sunset over the ocean. But when you push it for longer clips or more complex scenes, things start to fall apart. Objects glitch, movements distort, and the AI's limitations become painfully clear. And then there's the cost. High resolution, longer videos drain credits quickly, making Sora a pricey gamble. At this stage, it feels more like a proof of concept than a reliable creative tool. Is Sora worth it? For now, it's a niche tool with potential, if you can afford the steep price and are willing to work within its limits. Despite its current limitations, Sora's potential is hard to ignore. Think about where we were with AI-generated images just a few years ago. Tools like DALL-E and Midjourney started with glitches and quirks, but rapid advancements turned them into game changers for artists and designers. Sora could be on a similar path. Imagine a future where Sora can create Hollywood-quality videos from a single prompt. Filmmakers, content creators, and marketers could revolutionize how they produce videos, turning ideas into polished content in mere minutes. With improvements, we could see longer clips, consistent motion, and AI-generated stories that match the quality of human-made productions. The groundwork is there. OpenAI's continuous innovation means that what feels like a luxury or gimmick today could be a mainstream tool tomorrow. Sora might be paving the way for a world where creativity isn't restricted by skill or budget, only by imagination. So while Sora isn't perfect yet, it could be the first step toward the next video revolution, a powerful tool that transforms imagination into reality. But right now, it feels like an innovation that's just out of reach. The steep pricing, the technical limitations, and the frustrated backlash from users all paint a clear picture. We're standing at the edge of something incredible, but we're not there yet. OpenAI's challenge is clear. Will they refine Sora into a tool that's accessible to everyone, or will it stay locked behind a paywall, reserved for those who can afford it? Sora's potential is undeniable, but potential doesn't pay the bills or generate flawless videos. One thing's for sure, the future of AI-generated video is coming. The question isn't if AI will change video creation forever. The real question is, who gets to use it? Will it be a tool for the masses or a luxury for the few? Is Sora the future of AI video or just an overpriced gimmick? I want to hear your thoughts. Drop a comment below. And if you're into deep dives on AI and tech, don't forget to like and subscribe. The AI revolution is here, but who gets to benefit?